Okay, so now we're going to talk about the use of a buret. You can see buret is an instrument we use quite a bit in freshman chemistry. It's set up here on a stand. It's a buret clamp. We keep them in the lab. You mount it on the stand so that buret is sitting over the foot of the container. If you are working with a titration where you're looking for a color change, you usually want some white paper under it so you can see the color change more easily. Also, when you drain the buret, it's a good idea to have it go into an Erlenmeyer flask rather than a beaker. The Erlenmeyer is set up so that if there's any splashing, it stays in the container, whereas otherwise it will go out of the beaker. By the way, you'll notice I've got a lot of residual material here. I was testing the instrument before, so this isn't quite clean. That's just for the purposes of the demonstration. When you actually do an experiment in the laboratory, you want to start with clean glassware. Make sure you rinse everything carefully according to the instructions. Okay, so I've got some purple dye here. I'm going to show you how to load and use the buret. First order of business is to load it, get some solution in there. So we'll use a funnel to load it. That's much easier than trying to pour into that narrow neck. You won't spill solution everywhere. Just got some purple dye here. Just pouring that in. We'll let it fill up. All right, now a lot of students always feel they have to load the solution all the way to the very top, to the 0.00 line. You don't have to do that. Anywhere that you can read it is fine. You have to have the liquid level below the zero there and above the bottom line here at 25. If it's outside that range, you can't measure the volume you're delivering. Otherwise, you can use it at any level you want. Now, the other thing you need to do when you load it, once you've got the solution in here, you need to load the tip. You'll notice that right now, the tip there is empty. So what I'm going to do is turn this, let the solution run through, and then stop. And you can see the tip is now filled. It's hard, it may be hard to see, but there is solution in it now. There are no bubbles or anything. There's no leaking going on. This is how it's supposed to look. So you would load the tip that way. Chances are you've lost a few drops of solution along the way. Just dispose of those. All right. Now you're ready to take measurements. Now, let's look at the gradations here. If you look closely at the numbers here, you can see they're numbered from 0 at the top to 25 at the bottom. So here we have 7, 8, 9, and so on. You'll notice between each of the 1 milliliter markings is a 0.1 milliliter marking. So 7.1, 7.2, 7.3, and so on. Now remember the rules about significant figures. You always estimate the last digit. So looking at the gradations here, you would read this instrument to the hundredths place for milliliters. That is, you grade it down to the tenths place, 0.1 milliliters. You read it to 0.01. So looking at the liquid level here, let's try and get that measurement as the initial volume of solution, okay? So looking at this, you can see there's some curvature to the liquid there. That's called the meniscus. And you always take the measurement at the bottom of the meniscus. Also, when you do the measurement, get your eye level on the same level as the liquid level. So you're looking straight across. If you look up or down, you get something called parallax error, and that'll bollock your results. So you look straight across, and you check where the gradations sit. So I'm looking here. 8, 9, it's between 9 and 10 here, so it'll be 9 point something. The meniscus is definitely past the 9.1 line and past, I think, the 9.2. Looks to me like it's a bit shy of the 9.3 line. So I'm going to call it 9.25 milliliters as the initial level. So I will write that down then as 9.25 milliliters. Now I want to be very clear here. I did not write 9.2 or 9.3. That's wrong. I did not write 9.255. That's wrong. You measure to exactly two places past the decimal. You stop there. Okay. Now, if I want to deliver some volume of solution, my next step is to open the stopcock and let it drain through. Now, if I'm trying, let's say we're trying to deliver 1 milliliter, I try and get down to 10.25 mils. More often, you're doing a titration where you're delivering some volume of solution and watching for a color change. In which case, you're just slowly adding dropwise, you make a note of where you stop. But either way, you go until you stop. This particular buret, by the way, it looks like there's a small problem here. You can see a bubble has developed there. That means there's a little bit of a leak there. If you saw that happen in the lab, you'd probably want to go back and either start over with this buret or get yourself a different one. But we'll just go ahead with it from here. So I started at my 9.25. I'm just going to deliver some arbitrary amount here. Down we go. I'm going to let it run for a bit. And eventually, we'll get down to let's put it somewhere near 15. Okay, so now I'm going to look at that level again. Okay, so we're past the 15 line, but we're well short of the 15. So the reading is beyond 15. Looks to me like it's below 15.1, but less than 15.2. So I'm going to put it at 15.12. Okay, so I'll write that down then as 15.12 milliliters. And again,